It's been several weeks now since we last visited about reopening our churches, coming together, regathering for worship in the Diocese of Florida. And many things have changed in that time. I know many of you are worshiping once more in your churches, and that's a wonderful thing. I've been in four different congregations on Sunday mornings for regathered worship, two of those indoors and two of them outside, and all four have been wonderful experiences for me. I'm finding during this time of coronavirus and concern on the part of many of us about health issues that the outdoor worship is quite appealing and lovely. And in the couple of places where I've done that, I've really been attracted to it and captivated by it. If you're not doing outdoor worship and experimenting with that, you might want to give it a try. One thing I would say in light of the experience I've had in the last month or so is that we need to be very careful still. We need to be cautious, not move too quickly. We all have the same goal, and that is to come back together as the body of Christ. But we also share the goal of keeping our people, our children, our elderly, the most vulnerable among us, healthy. And so I want to say to you that while we're going to be flexible and leave the judgment about worship to the rector, to the vicar, to the lay leaders of parishes, I do insist that you stay in touch with the local county authorities about stages of reopening, and that all of the state laws concerning social distance, masking, and otherwise be obeyed. I'm hearing from a lot of our clergy who have been regathering that they are challenged and often distracted by paying attention to all the rules while they're trying to lead worship. And I hope that our lay leadership and the people in the pew will be considerate of them and assist them so that they can concentrate on preaching the word and doing the liturgy well. Help them by observing social distancing and all the other of our rules. No two congregations are the same. You all have good judgment and love the Lord and one another. And so I'm encouraging you to work together as we seek to regather. Know that this isn't going to happen overnight. It's going to be a slow process. I don't want us to hurry up and make mistakes. Let's do it right so that when the day comes that we really do regather fully, and when the churches look like they looked before, except with even more faces in them, that we will be ready to regather joyously and vigorously, and to bring still more into the fold to worship with us.